So today I'm here to talk to you about a really small but powerful tool in Python, the zip function. So here I have three lists. The first list contains a list of football clubs. The second list contains a list of strings, a list of integers that represent the year that each club was founded in. And our last list contains the total titles of each club. So let's imagine that we want to iterate over those lists and print the date that each club was founded in and the total titles that each club has. Okay, so what we could do, as you can notice here, every list has the same length. So we can simply use an index-based for loop. Like that. Oh, Football Clubs was founded in and it and has won shield titles. UEFA Champions League titles. Okay, let's run our program. Okay, so as you can see here, we have the FC Barcelona was founded in 1899 and has won 5 UEFA Champions League titles. However, here we can simplify this loop by a lot if we use the zip function that Python offers. So what the zip function actually does, it combines multiple iteratables, such as a list or dictionaries, into one iteratable. And that way we can simply avoid using index-based looping and our code can become much more readable. So let's try and write the same loop, but using the zip function, okay? We'll start by iterating club, year, and titles. And here we're going to use the zip function, clubs, founded, and total CL titles. And here we can simply change our strings with okay, so let's see if that actually works. Yeah, and as you can see, we managed to get the exact same output as before. Okay, so this is a case where the zip function made our code much more readable, but we can also use this zip function in order to create dictionaries from lists. So imagine that we want to create a dictionary called titles by club that contains as a key the name of each club and as a value the total number of titles that that club has. So what we could do, a naive way to approach this is we can simply use dictionary comprehensions. So for example, we could do football clubs and cell titles i in a range the length of the football clubs list. And let's actually print our dictionary. And we got what we actually wanted. Each key is the name of a club and the value is total number of titles. Okay. However, that's a much easier way to do it using the zip function. What we can do is simply parse the zip of football clubs and CL titles. And as you can see here, let me comment this out. If I run this program, we get the exact same output. When we use the zip function, we can actually iterate over multiple lists. We aren't actually obliged to iterate over two lists. We can actually use three or more, as I did before. Okay. So that was the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and stay tuned because we have more Python tutorials coming out soon.